The most watched cable news host has been stating for the last several nights that the NSA has been monitoring his communications. And amazingly, the NSA has issued a statement that is so couched, it is functionally an admission. Let's review. The NSA says, in an attempt to take this show off the air, close quote. This allegation is untrue. But which allegation? The statement continues. Tucker Carlson has never been an intelligence target of the agency. And the statement continues. But what's interesting is that there is no denial that they were monitoring Tucker Carlson, even if he wasn't the target. We saw this exact playbook with Carter Page and Donald Trump, where in order to try to assess information from one person, the intelligence community will utilize authorities to go after someone else to try to ensnare their true target. It's the reason they were going after Republican staff, perhaps to target Mr. Nunes or others. I think it's why they were going after Carter Page to get to Trump. And I think that there's probably somebody in Tucker Carlson's orbit that NSA was monitoring, and there's no denial that they caught up Tucker Carlson in that monitoring. And by the way, there's also no denial that there was a plan to leak the information to try to, in some way, embarrass Tucker Carlson. The only denial is that they weren't expressly trying to get his show off the air. If Democrats don't do this, if you're only outraged when your members and your staff and the press that's close to you and that amplifies your messages is targeted, then we never are going to solve anything. It will, in fact, be deja vu all over again, as Professor Turley said. I'm equally outraged when they target the people I like and the people I don't like. We're on a roll, Mr. Chairman. Last week, you brought big tech to heel. This week, bringing the Department of Justice to heel. My heart flutters to think what might be in our next committee week. Maybe we'll reform FISA and continue the bipartisan momentum. I believe that the Department of Justice and the intelligence community shouldn't threaten or spy on members of Congress, our staff, or the press for politics. President Biden believes the same thing. In response to questions from CNN's Caitlin Collins, President Biden committed that he would not allow the weaponization of his government against the press. Chairman Nadler agrees. Matter of fact, Chairman Nadler stated, and I'm quoting directly, Congress must make it extraordinarily difficult, if not impossible, for the department to spy on the Congress or the news media. We cannot rely on the department alone to make these changes. When I saw the reports about members of Congress offices being targeted, Mr. Swalwell, Mr. Schiff, I was the first and the only Republican to say that that was improper. And more of my colleagues should join me. It was easy to believe that the Department of Justice would do that to the Democrats because they threatened to do it to us. Mr. Chairman, I seek unanimous consent to enter into the record Fox News publication from September 27, 2018. Rosenstein launched hostile attack in May against Republicans over Russia records.
Without objection.
Rosenstein threatened Kash Patel, who was a member of Republican staff, with criminal process if he did not bend to what Mr. Rosenstein wanted at the time. So it's not hard to believe. The most watched cable news host has been stating for the last several nights that the NSA has been monitoring his communications. And amazingly, the NSA has issued a statement that is so couched, it is functionally an admission. Let's review. The NSA says, on June 28, 2021, Tucker Carlson alleged that the National Security Agency has been, quote, monitoring our electronic communications and is planning to leak them in an attempt to take this show off the air, close quote. This allegation is untrue. But which allegation? The statement continues. Tucker Carlson has never been an intelligence target of the agency, and the NSA has never had any plans to try to take his program off the air. And the statement continues. But what's interesting is that there is no denial that they were monitoring Tucker Carlson, even if he wasn't the target. We saw this exact playbook with Carter Page and Donald Trump, where in order to try to assess information from one person, the intelligence community will utilize authorities to go after someone else to try to ensnare their true target. I think that's why they were going after Democrat staff, to try to get to Schiff and Swalwell. I think it's the reason they were going after Republican staff, perhaps to target Mr. Nunes or others. I think it's why they were going after Carter Page to get to Trump. And I think that there's probably somebody in Tucker Carlson's orbit that NSA was monitoring, and there's no denial that they caught up Tucker Carlson in that monitoring. And by the way, there's also no denial that there was a plan to leak the information to try to, in some way, embarrass Tucker Carlson. The only denial is that they weren't expressly trying to get his show off the air. And it's not like the NSA's never lied to us. I mean, we were told that there was no bulk collection of Americans' data. Turns out there was bulk collection of Americans' data. And no one ever was held to account for that. The chairman's right. And Professor Turley's right, too. We cannot count on these people to police themselves. And so it's my expectation that there needs to be greater review here. And so, Mr. Chairman, I am inviting you to continue this bipartisanship. Join me in calling for inspector general investigation into any monitoring that the NSA or any other element of the intelligence community has engaged in relative to Tucker Carlson. Because these denials, these couch denials, raise more questions than they provide answers. And by the way, if Democrats don't do this, if you're only outraged when your members and your staff and the press that's close to you and that amplifies your messages is targeted, then we never are going to solve anything. It will, in fact, be deja vu all over again, as Professor Turley said. I'm equally outraged when they target the people I like and the people I don't like, when they target the press that I watch and the press that I despise. And I would greatly seek any bipartisan agreement. Last week, we were on such a roll. We brought big tech to account. And my hope is that we can join together again and address this legislatively, but specifically with a call for an inspector general investigation into these allegations. I yield back.